Hey friends, it's Reverend Ben. This is your weekly video. Our chalice lighting today comes from the UU World. Do you read our magazine? We have this spectacular magazine in the denomination called the UU World. There is our phenomenal president of the Unitarian Universalist Association, Reverend Dr. Sophia Betancourt, and contained within these pages are many things, including this week's chalice lighting by Otto O'Connor, who says, "Beauty is not a distraction from the troubles of the world. We are here not to protect our hearts from breaking. A broken heart is full of beauty." Frederick Buckner said, "Here is the world. Beautiful and terrible things will happen. Don't be afraid. It's the terrible things that put the beauty in sharp relief. My message to you," says Otto, "is to allow yourself to see that beauty, to find it, to create it amidst the reality of our world, to treasure its fleetingness, and then to let go. It's a way to survive. It's an act of rebellion to see this true beauty around us." Maybe so. Thank you, Reverend Otto. That is our chalice lighting. Got a lot going on this week. On Thursday from 9 to 1 is the final work day for the tiny home. Susan Gore, I've seen there a lot, and many other volunteers. You contact Sabina if you're interested in helping out with the tiny home this week. On Saturday, I and April are going to carpool and escort at the abortion clinic in Clearwater at Bread and Roses. We will, if you've never done this before, we will give you an introduction to what happens in the car ride north. So if anyone's interested, we'll probably leave, probably meet in the church parking lot or somewhere, maybe at 9 a.m., but definitely contact me or April if you're interested in that. And that brings us to Sunday, continuing in our month-long theme of pluralism. Allison Longkey and Gordia LeClaire are leading us on a journey called "What Does Pluralism Mean to You?" I'm really excited for that. I'm not leading worship, but I will be live streaming. So if you want to learn how to live stream, contact me. It's fun. It's the setup is not easy. The actual live streaming part is easy, but the setup part has been made easier because of Cheyenne, of course, who made a very thorough booklet on exactly what to do. Then comes the annual meeting after Sunday. You all are voting on my letter of agreement. You all are voting on the slate that we have for our new leaders for the next church year, including new board members. Thank you so much to the nominating committee and to those willing to serve. You are voting on our budget. There's only going to be coffee after the worship service so that folks aren't busy eating. They can get back to the sanctuary in time for the annual meeting. So if you need snacks in between, or if you're hypoglycemic like me, and you really need snacks, feel free to bring your own. Then next Thursday night is our monthly board meeting. They're all open to the public. That's Thursday night, May 23rd, I believe 5:30 p.m., Conway South. And then we have my installation on Saturday, May 25th. Now, hospitality needs some help with some setup, with some food, and with some cleanup. The menu items that they need are in our weekly newsletter. And speaking of our newsletter, the mingles are going really well. The details on those are in the newsletter. I believe the next one is Sunday, May 26th, pizza night at the Video Arcade owned by Allison and Greg Longkey. Did you know they owned a video arcade? I can't wait to go. And that's just a $15 donation to UU St. Pete. Once June happens, we're going to participate in a lot of Pride events. Gulfport Pride on June 1st, St. Pete Pride Family Day on June 8th, and the St. Pete Pride Parade on June 22nd. That brings us right to our annual General Assembly, It's virtual this year from June 20th to 23rd. I urge everyone to register and participate. And we're going to try to have some events where we have a watching party at UU St. Pete. So stay tuned for that. I want to thank the four delegates that we get from UU St. Pete that the board appointed. And office volunteers are needed. Some of our office volunteers are taking a break and some are going north. So contact Lauren Collins. Thank you, Lauren Collins, for Connor, pardon me. Thank you, Lauren Connor, for volunteering to organize those volunteers. Lauren Connor. When we extinguish this chalice, that's when we ignite it in ourselves. And that flame within us is an unquenchable flame. We're going to keep that lit till we see one another again. Take care. Have a good week. Blessings.